Notice anything different? Yeah, so it turns out the Civic radiator is a great fit, but the two-row just wasn't doing it. So went ahead and got a three-row. It was actually surprisingly cheap. I think this one was like the $75 fake Mishimoto off of eBay. I've also made a nifty little holder for the coolant coolant return bottle. This is not it's not an expansion system, meaning this bottle will only receive any coolant in the case of overheating, where you know the radiator cap has it basically has a pressure rating on it. When that pressure exceeds what it's rated for, it will lift up a sort of a gate that it has built into itself, and then all the excess coolant will flow through this hose into here. On older Volvos, it just basically had, I can show you actually on my existing radiator, it had this hard line that basically just dumped it to ground. And so on this one, I got the, you know, this is just your stock aftermarket, like, universal bottle. Just fabricated a little holder for it. Over here, I have finally a proper connector that accepts my temperature sensor. The wiring's still a bit loosey-goosey. I need to get some zip ties and secure this. And here is a, you know, a lot of RTV gasket maker. I just, you know, better safe than sorry. Just put that stuff everywhere, tighten the hoses as much as I could. And so the electrical part of it is you've got the temperature sensor over here. And that is wired to this relay, and you can see I have it labeled. It's not the relay to just any old fan, it's the rad fan. Sorry, couldn't help it. But yeah, it's an electric fan mounted to the front of that frame. I, you know, fabricated some brackets on the front that the fan can bolt to. So the relay, basically all the switch does, the switch is getting its power from the ignition switch through a little 5 amp fuse, just in case things get crazy and there's a short somewhere. And all it does is open and close this relay. Now this relay is getting powered directly from the battery through a 30 amp fuse, because the fan is going to draw a lot more current. And all the switch is doing is controlling the ground, whether that circuit connects to ground, thus opening or closing the circuit on the relay. And the relay is also just got a ground cable that then grounds to a common point in the car, and then the power, actually the plus 12 volts, is going straight to the fan. And that is the most secure way of doing a circuit like this. Anyway, this is the new fan. I have to now, I just finished connecting the bottom hose. And by the way, thanks a lot to David Bellow for all the information that he provided about the radiator plumbing and
what hoses to use and whatnot. I really suggest you watch his build videos. I'll put the link in the description. He has what's probably the most complete series of videos on YouTube about restoring and rebuilding an Amazon, and now he's on to restoring a wagon. So yeah, I really, really recommend you watch his stuff. Okay, so back to my radiator. All I need to do now is fill it up with coolant. I left the RTV silicone to dry overnight. The instructions say, I think it cures enough that you can fill it up within 4 hours, and it takes 24 hours to fully cure. So it's been well over 14 hours to this point, so I assume it's safe to fill it up. Let's see. It seems pretty solid. It's not tacky at all. So yeah, let's fill it up. Because that one would not even take an entire gallon, and this one I'm almost completely done with this gallon. Good thing I bought a second one. It's got an air bubble somewhere. So now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna leave the radiator cap off and just give it a few cranks so that if there's any air trapped in the system, it will come out the top. Now I've given it a few cranks. You can see that everything seems fine up here. Now what I need to do is finish my fuse boxes, and then I'll run the car again. Fuse boxes will be in a separate video, but I will post me turning the car on again to this same video. So just know that the next video in the series actually is what goes on in between this point and afterwards when you see the car turning on. Okay, fuse blocks are wired up again. Battery is reconnected and hopefully charged. I know this battery is on its way out. That's next on my list of things to buy is probably an Optima battery. But anyway, this one should be charged now. Let's try starting it. Alright, apart from that squeaking, everything else seems to be good. So, now my next task is to find out where the squeaking is coming from. But, as far as the radiator and cooling system goes, I would say, job done. Of course, the real test will be when I'm driving the car, seeing, you know, how well it's cooling the engine and how well it's coping. I just, at this hour, I can't run my car for very long in the garage because I don't have adequate venting of the exhaust. So, yeah, as far as radiator goes, job done. On to the next thing. Thanks for watching.